I am certain that Prime Minister Pandranaike would have done the same. I would like to recall his memory this evening. It is he who made Sri Lanka aware of the Oxford Union. Sri Lanka has a lot of admirers and followers of the Oxford Union in our little country, and all that comes from the W.R.D. Pandranaike, whose daughter today is the president of the country, twice elected president, and she spoke at the Union in a year or two. I'd also like to remember another colleague, Lalit Athulak Mudali, who was president 1 year ahead of me. He went into politics very young, and he built for himself a very fine career indeed. And as he was at the prime of his political career, he was failed by the bullet of an assassin. Mr. President, the Union has done me a very great honor. I am deeply conscious of that and deeply appreciative of that. I would like, if I may, to assume that I can share that honor with the people of Sri Lanka. Because I am very much a product of Sri Lanka. I had my schooling there, my first university was there, I went to the law college, and by the time I came to Oxford as a postgraduate student, well, I was a reasonably mature person. Oxford, I think, was the icing on the cake, but the cake was baked at home.